Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTrainingSystem.com. All right, so we are now at day seven, I think, of the boot camp. So today we will talk about the day that happened. It was a very difficult day, and I think it's a very interesting day because training wouldn't be fun if it was not difficult, right? So let's first start by talking about the dashboard again, because it's important that you know how to use it so that you can improve your trading. Okay, so far we have 26 days, 256 trade, and if we take all the trades, we will be at 72%, which is enough to make money, right? So we need 70% at least to make a little bit of money, and yeah, we're at 72%. So it shows that this strategy, even if you take all the trades, then you will be profitable. Not you will not win 1 million, but you will still not be negative. Okay. We can also see I put a line basically at 70%. 70% is what we need to be profitable, and we can see that most of the days that we have taken into account are above this 70% line. Now, what I advise you to do is to take a look at those days where we have less than 50%, because what you want to do is to avoid taking trades, not avoid taking trades, but avoid days where you have a 50% win rate, okay? Because this will mean that your account will not be on the white, on the green side. So, for example, I'm starting to look at data in January. I will put data February, March, because what I want is to have something representative during the year, right? It's not because it works, it seems to work good in June and July, that it worked good in January and in March or April. We need to have more data to be able to understand what's happening. So I will take a look at this on January. What happened is that a lot of days were counter trend. So yeah, I'm also doing something where I'm looking on the day of the week, because often I have a question, which day is the best to trade? So we will be able to know basically once after the 30 days, which day on the week is the better one. For now, it's saying that Monday, Wednesday and Friday are the best one to trade, and Tuesday and Thursday might maybe be avoided. But let's see, we don't have enough data for it to be significant. On the parameters, so as we see, always the good candlestick with the trend and early in the party are the parameters that you need to have. Of course, if you have a Papa score that is between 0 and 1, you should avoid taking the trade. Another parameter that is also important, it's congestion, right? So if you see that if you are in congestion, your winning rate is 70%. If you are not in congestion, it's 86%, right? So you should avoid taking trade if you are in congestion. If you look at the candlestick, so funny is if the candlestick is 2.25 or 2.5 size, you have a good winning rate. If it's two, you have two or less, you have a bad winning rate. So maybe you should avoid taking trade where the candlestick size is two or less. But anyway, we don't have enough data size, we need more. In the candlestick, so candlestick pattern, I didn't find anything quite significant on it. What you will see also is on the left-hand side, you have so statistic on the show you punish, but also on the market structure. Because as I said to you, if you want to improve, it's not only about how to say show you punish, but also about understanding the market structure, right? If you have the show you punish, you will maybe be able to reach 80% win rate. If you have the market structure, you will probably be able to reach 90%, right? Because you need to understand if you're in range, not in range, when it's good to take reversal trades, and so on, right? So you can take a look at this. I uploaded a few days. The resolution on the dashboard is not that good, but if you want a better resolution, you just have to click on the image, right? So if you want to understand what was the market structure on the 2nd of July, you can just click over here and you will have a better resolution, right? So 1, 2, 3, after 3. So usually what I say is if you have a failed 3 or a 4, that's the moment to take a reversal, okay? Trade. If you are in a range, of course, you shouldn't apply the same rules. So you need to short on the top of the range, or you need to long on the bottom of the range, okay? Anyway, so this was one of it. Third is also, I added another thing where I'm trying to see if the ship has an importance on the fact of taking trace or not. For the moment, I haven't really found anything interesting. Maybe if AB lower than CD and BC lower than DE, then we should avoid taking the trades. But I'm still looking at what should be the trade to look at. I also put a tab if you want to deep dive on specific days. So for example, what I was looking at is why on the 3rd June and on the 2nd June we had 50%, right? So what we can see is that those days were overrepresented on days with one on the Papa score. Okay, so of course if you have days with a lot of one on the Papa score, you'll have more trade that fails. Okay, so you can see by candlestick and so on. But anyway, so now that this is said, let's take a look at the trading day. Okay, so yesterday, as I said, was a very, very difficult day, and the reason is because we had basically a range day, but a range day without clear support and clear resistance. Okay, so what you should do when you start looking at the day is to first start looking at what happened pre-market. So pre-market, you can see that basically the day was starting in a range. Okay, so it was bouncing between up, down. Then when it started, so you can see here that it did a first impulse over here, then it did impulse on the downside, then the price did a range again. So when you see this, right, as I said, what you should try to do when you see candles closing at the same level, you should draw your range. So here it's closing on the same level. So you can put it here. Here it's closing at the same level. Okay. So it closes here, it closes here, it closes here, it closes here. And then here, what you are trying to do when you are in a range, right, is the only way to play a range is to buy at the bottom of it, okay, or sell at the top of it. Okay. So on this case, there was probably some fail to get pullback. And this one is interesting, as I'm saying, because it's like you have a range here, it breaks, it comes up again. Okay, and what you will be buying is that you will be buying at the bottom of the range. So even though this candlestick is not that good, okay, I think that this thing is still okay to take. Okay, then it push up, but it push up really, 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 really in a messy way, right? You see, it's pushing like this, but the candles are overlapping, and then I have this top, right? So maybe you wouldn't have been able to see it, because sometimes me also when I trade I only see this. Okay, I don't look at candles that are above, right, that are far beyond. But if you had your chart, you would have seen that here you are making like a double bottom, a double top. But anyway, even though you haven't seen it, normally you should be able to see that the price is ranging over here, right? It's doing a range, so it's doing a top. So first it did two candles that close at the same level, and then what you should do is to also draw over here, like it's closing at the same level. So here we have a Pikachu, okay, which is happening at the top of the range, but this thing is kind of scary, okay, because you see that the range between year and year is, you have your 1 point scalp, so you could take it, right, but it's still dangerous because it's in a lot of congestion. Okay, so by the way, what I always say is those type of trade, so usually I will do this, I will connect as much high as possible, so this close here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can see that here you have a hammer type of candlestick. So this is the only type of two-legged pullback that I will try to take on a trade. Okay, so with a hammer it does a two-legged pullback, and of course it does a failed two-legged pullback, so it's a Pikachu. So I'm not sure if I would have taken it, but it would have been an okay trade to take. But this thing is concerning. Okay, here after it goes on the downside, and then it does again like a type of range, right? So it does an impulse, impulse, and then a range. Okay, so that here you can see over here, if you are trying to take like a long over year, it would have been complicated, right? So so if you haven't taken any trade, it's fine. I think that, as I said, it's a very difficulty. You need to look carefully at what is these days and what are the trades that you could have taken. So this one is one of them. This one is one of them. And I also want to talk about this one. Okay, so this trade over here. Okay, so this is basically an external, not an external, an outside bar. Okay, but how you could basically, so me, when I trade. So what I'm showing you here is how to trade only looking at chart. As some might know, normally how I trade is I always have the depth of market and the order book. But what I want to show you today is something specific, okay? I want to show you something called the footprint, which basically shows you at a candle level, where are the forces. So the force, is it more seller, is it more buyer, where we have something called absorption or not. So you don't need to take it into account into your training on the bootcamp, but I want to show it to you because I do think, in my personal opinion, I do think that it's when you have a range day, it's always good to understand the power of the candle. So meaning that, do we have a good chance that the candle is going to go up, or do we have a good chance that the candle is going to go down? So for this, I'm going to expose something called the footprint. Okay, so to have the footprint, I'm not sure. First, to have the footprint, I think that you need to have the lifetime license of NinjaTrader, but I'm not sure of it. Okay, so if people want to have it, what I advise you to do is to click right on your chart, do data series. Okay, and then you will have something on the type. So create a new chart, and then on the type, you take volumetric, tick, and 2000. Okay, so once you have this, you will have a chart that is like this. Okay, so what it will give you is the volume that are on the bid and on the ask. Okay, so what you want to do also, what I take in the configuration is that I keep only the delta. Okay, so you click on show bar statistic and delta bar. Okay, so the delta bar over here, it shows you basically what is the so it will do the difference between the buyers, okay, those who buy market, which is on the right, and those who sell market, which is on the left. Okay, so if it's positive, that means that the buyer were in control. So for example, on this candle, you can see that the delta is very high, 1,156. That means we had 1,156 market orders more on the buy side than on the sell side. Okay, so this is one important thing to take a look at. Another important thing, so as I said, so maybe I will take my drawing tool. Okay, so I'm going to expand this stuff. Okay, so just for you to understand a little bit what this means, right? So let's say I have this. Okay. Oh, yeah. So you can see that the stuff is divided into two. You have what is on the left and what is on the right. Okay, so whatever is on the left, okay, so let's say I take 148, is people that market order. Okay, 148 people has market order to sell. Okay, yes. Okay, so these are people that are selling at market. Okay, and on the opposite diagonal, okay, is people that are buying. So 371 are people that bought, right? Bought market, right? So buy at a market. So to push the price up, you need to basically buy on this side, okay? And to push the price down, people have to sell on this side, okay? So what I'm looking at three elements, okay? So there is three elements on this type of chart that you need to understand. So first, there is something called the point of control. Point of control is the so it's where I have my yellow type of thing over here on the right is on the candle where is the volume. Okay, the highest volume that has been traded within this candle is here, and it's called the POC, so the point of control. Okay. Second thing that I will look at is I will look at something called imbalance. So imbalance is what is when the diagonal, okay, between the sell and the buy. So let's say here it's 132, and we can see that it's in pink. So it's because there is more people that has shorted, okay, here the volume of short was higher than people who try to long. So there is an imbalance. So the more you have imbalance on a candle, the more there is pressure on the downside. Okay. Third element I look at is this delta. Okay. So I take a look at what is the power of the sell side. Okay. But now, how do I use all those elements when I trade? Okay. The important stuff that I look at is something called absorption. Okay. So if I take a look at this trade that I wanted to point out, so this one over here, that happened here, so it happened over here. What we can see, so I'm going to zoom a little bit, okay, is here you can see, right, we have 885 people that tried to market sell, okay, over here, and the price didn't go down. And we have a huge delta that are minus 720. So when we have this, that means that people are trying to push the price on the downside, okay, but the price is not going down. So that means that the buyer, there is some limit order over here that are buying all this. So this is called absorption, meaning that some people are trying to push down, but they cannot because people are buying on here. Okay, so it acts as a support. And then on the very next candle, we have the same thing at the same level. Okay, so when I usually see this, that give me the sign that if I buy over here, so I had a two-legged pullback, a failed two-legged pullback, so up, so A B C D E, okay, and then here you will see, I will show you my live trade. When I saw this happening, it was a sign for me. I placed a buy stop right above this candle because I knew that the price, okay, had a very low chance to come back lower than this point, okay? Because as I said to you, it tried two times. It tried two times to push the price down, okay? So 885 and 721, but when it tried, the price never shoot down. It always came up, okay? So this is usually a good indication that the price cannot be pushed on the lower side. And this is what I'm looking at basically when I'm looking at this footprint chart. I'm looking to see whenever there is absorption. Okay, so let me show you because what I do usually is that I film. So I traded on the first hour of the market, and then after I went for lunch and so on. And then I will keep the video running because on the weekend I will see again what's happening, right? So let me show you. So this is what happened when I was live, okay? So let me play the video. It happened at minutes 17, 28. So look at this candle forming and look over here, right? So here I see this, I dezoom. You can see that here I had put the range, right? And I draw my impulse, right? And then here you see it started 677, right? And then I see absorption here. I see again absorption here. 420 versus 0, 421 versus 0. Then what I do is that I place a buy stop. You're gonna see I'm gonna place a buy stop over here on the top of the candle, okay? Because I see that it's absorbed. So if the price comes back and touch over here, I will be on the trade. I have my failed two-legged pullback, and I'm pretty confident that if it breaks over here, then I will have the price that will shoot up. So here I wait, I see here those two absorptions, so I'm very confident that here the price is going to go to my 1 point scalp. So I just have to wait, and it will happen normally. So it's still grinding down, and boom, I have my 1 point scalp that happened, right? So this is how basically, as I said, I use whenever I have a failed trigger pullback that happened, and I want to anticipate the move, and I want to understand. Does it have a good chance that this is a support zone? Okay. I will look basically at the order flow. So normally, I will not look at the order flow. I will look at so the footprint. I will look at the depth of market. But since I know that a lot of people doesn't have a level 2 data, they can still access this without having level 2 data because these are market orders that already happened. It's not limit orders. Okay. So this is one way of looking at it, and I have several trades where I always look at this one. Example, if you see on my chart, I will have some zones here where I say order flow craziness, order flow battle. So what does it mean here? Is that I'm looking at this chart basically. Okay, so let's take a look over here. Why did I put order flow craziness on this specific candle, right? So you can see over here that I had the price that did a market order 287 versus 47. So here, and I have this bubble over here. So this means again that people try to push the price down, okay? But they didn't succeed, right? So they didn't succeed, meaning that they got absorbed, okay? So of course, you should not take trade on every single absorption, right? It's not because there is an absorption that it will always go up. But those are places, specifically here, it happened at the top of the channel. So the channel was acting as support, right? So what I'm looking is the order, the footprint, and I'm also looking at the structure of the chart, right? So if it's happening on the bottom of the chart, then I know that so at the bottom of the basically the range, and I have like absorption, I know that it's a high chance it's going to be a support, right? And I feel that if you are missing this information, you are missing really on something, because you need to understand where are the forces. Are they on the buy side, or are they on the short side, or are the buy getting absorbed, or are the sell getting absorbed? Okay, so this was one of them. Here you can see over here on this candle, I can see that people try to push the price higher. So I have 537 and then 380. So I can see that again, the price got absorbed over here. So what you can do, right, when you use this strategy, is that you can place a limit order over here and have a very tight stop loss. Maybe a stop loss that is one tick above those two bars. So if you lose, you don't lose a lot, but if you win, but you can win like 4 ticks. So it would be like a 2 ticks stop loss for a 5-6 ticks win. Okay, so I often use this strategy. I'm trying to include it on the fail to legged pullback. Of course, as I said, you don't need to use it. This is more of a bonus, but I want you to be aware of what I'm using. Okay, as I said, I'm not hiding anything. I'm showing you everything that I use in order for you guys to succeed, right? So if you want to, me, what I do usually when I trade is that I will have my chart over here, and then I will have the order flow on the bottom. I will just take a look at it a little bit. And of course, I will zoom. I don't need like 20 candles. I need to see the 5-6 candles. So I'll focus on looking at my failed to legged pullback and market structure. And then when a move happens, I will try to see if I have like some absorption to give me like a confirmation. Okay, so I don't want to confuse you too much, guys. I think that the way you should start first is first understand market structure, understand like failed to legged pullback. And then once you start maybe on day 20 or day 25, once you start to get used to it, you can maybe try to put the footprint into your chart, because I think that it adds a huge value to understand where are the forces. Okay, so for example, here on the Pikachu that happened over here, we can see, right, that the delta was negative. So the force was on the downside, but here we didn't have clear indication on where the candle will go. Okay, we can see over here before, right, prior to it, the price tried to push higher, so 528, 87.0. Right, and failed, right? So this was already an indication that the price was starting to lose steam over here. With all those candles over here, you could see that the price was trying to push higher, 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 but it always never, it never did, right? They were trying to by doing market order, but then it went one tick above and then went down. So this is an indication, a sign that that the power is not that much on the upside. Okay. Anyway, I hope this video was useful. As I say, it was a very difficult day, so don't blame yourself if you maybe lost. Probably, if I traded the entire day, I would have maybe lost also, because it needs like clear patience to be able to overcome those type of days. Okay. All right, this was Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com. See you on the next video.